The reason why it's so important for Honeypot to do well is so the next black girl that comes up with a great idea, she could have a better opportunity. That means a lot to me.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. What was meant to be an ad to celebrate a black-owned brand during Black History Month turned into the founder facing Twitter fingers, internet trolls, and negative reviews. But that didn't stop her from stirring the pot into some sweet honey. I like that. Please welcome founder and CEO of the Honey Pot, Beatrice Dixon.
Hi.
Hey, B.
How you doing?
I'm so well. How are you?
I'm so good.
Good,
yeah,
good.
I'm
you
so
look
good.
Just, you look radiant.
Thank you.
Yes, yes. Before we talk about what has transpired over the last few weeks.
Yes.
Can you tell everybody how Honeypot even came about?
Honeypot came about because I had an infection that I could not get rid of. And so the mother of invention is necessity.
Yes.
I went to sleep one night. I had a dream with one of my ancestors. She gave me a list of ingredients, told me that this would basically heal me.
Yeah.
And told me to wake up. And I remembered and wrote it down and made it, and it worked.
And it worked.
Yeah.
And that, they say, is history.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, my goodness.
Yeah.
Of course, you know, you were the first, one of the first black women to raise $1 million capital, over $1 million.
Over a million, yes.
How will you continue to inspire other women to do the same, and how hard was that to do?
I don't know what number I was, but maybe like one of the 50.
Yeah.
First 50 women.
One of 40, I think.
Yeah, something like that. But it was, I mean, it's hard for anybody to raise money. It's just hard to do. But I think that the reason why it's extra hard for African American women, you know, led businesses to raise money is because there haven't been a lot of us that have actually like scaled, especially in my type of business in consumer packaged goods, right? There haven't been a lot that have sold. And that's what venture capitalists look at, right? And so I think because there haven't necessarily been a lot, it can be looked at as a bit of a risk factor, which is crazy.
Yeah.
But you know, this is the day and age that we live in.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
we have to work really hard to make sure that we change that.
Right. On Monday in our Full Circle, we had a chance to honor a woman who we feel like has done amazing things, and I had a chance to honor you,
you
on Monday, and as we continue to lift up women for Women's History Month. But who are some of the women that have given you advice, and what's the best piece of advice outside of the ancestor that visited you in that dream that you've received?
Actually, my mother.
Yeah.
My mommy gave me the best advice that I've ever had in my life. She told me, because there was a time when I wasn't happy.
Mm-hmm.
And she told me that she's like, you're gonna die one day, right?
Right.
And so you need to figure out how to get yourself together, because if you're gonna die, then you really need to learn how to live.
Wow.
You know?
Right.
And that was the best piece of advice that I've ever gotten in my life.
Right, absolutely. And you know, when you see everything around the success of Honeypot, and then you see it trending, because some people took offense to what was meant to uplift not only girls of color, but all girls.
Mm-hmm.
What did you say when this was starting to happen? I know how you deal with things because you're like very, very cool, but how did you feel when
happening? I felt fine. I didn't have any feeling because I didn't take on somebody else's point of view, right? That doesn't have anything to do with me. That has everything to do with them.
Right.
So I felt completely fine. You know, I'm an innovator. I make products, right? Like, that's what I do. So when you do that and that has become your life's work, you really can't be emotional about people's perception.
Yes.
Because not everybody's gonna be able to use your product, and not everybody's also gonna like, not everybody is gonna like what you have to say.
Yes.
And so that's how I think, that's how I live my life.
Yeah.
And so I didn't really react at all.
Yeah.
We just went to our publicists. What do we need to do? What's the next steps? And then our customers really came in and saved the day.
Yeah,
you know?
We all did. And now the media attention has been so much. How do you take this and kind of run with it? Or are you just continuing to just stand in your truth?
I'm just continuing to stand in my truth, man.
Yeah.
And just be authentic.
Yeah.
But I picked the baton, though. I got it. I caught it. You know what I mean?
Right.
I'm going to take advantage of it because we're here now.
Yeah.
this is what the present moment mm-hmm. has served us. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I'm always here for whatever's here.
Right. What can women of color do, take from this experience to make sure that we remain at the forefront of not only this industry, but all industries?
Be responsible. Be responsible with your business. Mm-hmm. Be responsible with your employees. Be responsible as a human.
Yeah.
Right? Like, if you have the opportunity to make something that can be successful, be responsible with it and do it well.
Yes.
And know that you're really building the comps for the next business that's coming to do it. So take that seriously.
Yes, right.
Because if you don't, it can be bad. It would be different if there were thousands of us that have scaled and grown and sold and all that, but that's not the case.
Yeah.
You know, maybe in 10 years this will be a different conversation, mm-hmm. but right now we have to be responsible.
Yes. How does it feel to know that you are a role model to so many people? Have you taken that on?
It's weird for me a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm here for it, yeah. You know, because you always want to inspire. I just want to inspire myself. You know, so mm-hmm. So I take it on, but it is different.
Yeah.
Because, you know, even to say that I'm a humble, like, non-egotistical person sounds weird, right? Because if you are that, then you don't have to say that. But that's really, like, how I talk, these aren't sound bites. Like, I really live this way.
I know.
So it's like, it's beautiful. But it is different for me.
Well, you are the person to do the work, and you have done the work, and it shows. I love being in your presence.
Thank
you. I love who you are as a woman. You inspire me every single day.
Thank you.
Since we met back at the Chase event, and you're continuing to inspire me to this day. Thank you so much for being with us today. For more information on her products and new products, please visit her website at thehoneypot.co. And the conversation continues at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms. Beatrice Dixon, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.